Hey expats and trappers of life, today we're here to talk about expat life in Stockholm. We've broken it down into three parts: moving, living, and working. I'm Josh with Expats Everywhere.
And I'm Kaylee.
And this is our review preview show.
Stockholm ran away with this poll at 44% of your vote, so let's get started with moving there.
Stockholm is the biggest city in Sweden, but there are still parts of it that have a small city feel. Although it's spread out and there are many different types of neighborhoods, you will find that some areas have small, winding cobblestone streets, which can give you that small city feel.
The city is quite enchanting, with beautiful homes running along the river and different waterways. Stockholm is full of lots of different waterways and islands, and it's located right on the Baltic Sea, so lots of water and lots of bridges.
That's right. Stockholm has a rich history and charming architecture with lots to offer. You can get a great mix of the old feel and the new feel. So, what neighborhood fits you? We're going to break down a few, but since we don't speak Swedish and aren't even going to attempt these names, we have asked a fellow YouTuber, Victor, to help us out. Victor's from Sweden. He has a YouTube channel about mindset and mental health, and he's a great friend of ours.
Okay, Victor, take it away on the first district.
Hi guys, thank you for letting me help you pronounce these words for you. I'm gonna do my best, even though I'm from the south of Sweden. So some people in Sweden think I talk Danish, but I'm gonna do my best, so let's give it a try. Maybe you can guess where I'm from in the comments below. This word is a tough one because it includes two R, but here we say Norrmalm.
This district is right down in the center, and it's where many government buildings are, so if that's what brings you to Stockholm, then this district is for you. Also, those of you in the financial industry will be interested in this area, as it's not just the city's banking and financial center, but also the whole country's. It's extremely central and well connected to the whole city, but there aren't many housing options there, so it's more like offices and touristy areas, but it's a good place to hang out and be. Great district.
Next up,
Södermalm.
This district is becoming known as trendy or hipster, but it has a lot of historical buildings too. For those of you who enjoy the nightlife, this district is the one you want to live in. It has actually been ranked by Vogue as the coolest neighborhood in all of Europe. With a great mix of green spaces and modern architecture, you can get a great vibe here. Now, the biggest issue is since it's so popular and you want to live here, you're going to have to pay for it. Houses are in high demand, so the prices are high.
Moving on to this neighborhood.
Rinkeby, Kista.
This neighborhood is in the north, and there's a lot of IT and tech companies here, so if you're moving to Stockholm for that field, then you might end up here. This area has been known to be multicultural and entrepreneurial.
Another similar district is this one.
Vasastan.
With a lot of IT companies here as well, this district is expensive though, and is known to be quite fashionable and posh. There are some restaurants and bars, but this neighborhood isn't known for its nightlife.
This district,
Bromma,
caters more to families, so if you want this quiet vibe, then this is the place for you. It's a bit out of the city center, but it's close to one of the airports.
Now let's get to this area.
Solna/Sundbyberg.
It has cheap housing and is close to the center, which is super well connected, so commuting is easy. There is a lot of green space, and this is not the area you want to be for bars. It's just not that type of scene. Next is this district.
Älvsjö.
It is more residential and green. It's fairly modern, but it has nice touches of history, like this church.
Church of Brännkyrka.
It was built in the 12th century and is in this neighborhood.
Now the weather is something to be aware of before you move there. While the summers are warm and pleasant, it's not uncommon for the winters to get below 0 degrees Celsius. So be prepared for cold weather and not many daylight hours during the winter. That's not for me. But summers are quite pleasant and enjoyable, and the temperatures are more comfortable during the summer.
Now let's get to living in Stockholm. Like we've said, Stockholm offers amazing mixes of modern and traditional. So you can get either one depending on which area of the city you're in. It's great to check out the beautiful government buildings and the narrow streets. You can walk along the water. You can sit at a cafe for a cup of coffee. There's really a lot to do.
Stockholm is known for their tech industry as well as some great startups there. So even if you aren't moving there for that, you can see the different advances throughout the city. They also have done a good job at highlighting the natural beauty of the city.
Get this, English is widely spoken throughout the city, so you can definitely get by without knowing Swedish, but it's always great for the locals when other cultures come into their country and at least try to speak some Swedish, so keep that in mind. The locals are really friendly and they're really easy to get along with.
For those of you with kids, the Swedish education system might be a little different than what you're used to in your home country, but there are plenty of international schools available. Their education is known worldwide for being high quality.
That's true, and the public education is free, but you of course have to pay for international schools, and like most places, the cost of international schools is not cheap. It's on the higher end in Stockholm just because the cost of living is higher.
Speaking of paying for things and the cost of living, let's break down some costs for you. Stockholm is pretty pricey. A one-bedroom apartment in the city center will cost you around $1,500 USD a month, and a three-bedroom around $2,400. If you move out of the city center, for a one-bedroom it's closer to $1,000 USD, and a three-bedroom closer to $1,500. So it's great to be in the city center, but you will pay for it. Utilities are around $85 monthly, and internet and such, $30 monthly.
A meal at an inexpensive restaurant will cost you around $15, and a three-course meal for two at a mid-scale restaurant would be around $90. A beer is pricey at around $8, and a coffee $5.
The metro is very well connected. You can get a single ride for around $4, and it allows you to switch the metro, buses, ferries, and those things for about 75 minutes. You also have the option of a 24-hour, 72-hour, or 7-day ticket. The best thing to buy is a travel card, though, which is $2, and you reload it. It's better than buying a single ticket. You can also choose to get the app that they have as well.
Yeah, you can of course get a monthly pass if you're planning on using public transportation regularly. This will cost you around $105 monthly. The biggest thing to note is that you can't purchase a ticket on board with just a couple of exceptions. So be sure to get your travel card before boarding.
We've already talked a bit about the different neighborhoods, but a quick note about apartment hunting. The search can be a bit difficult because of the housing shortage. Like we talked about, housing can be pricey. Knowing a little bit of Swedish is definitely helpful, or have a friend or colleague who is from Sweden assist you.
There is something in the city known as first-hand and second-hand rental agreements. First-hand is getting the actual contract, and second-hand is subletting. Either way, you need a contract. First-hand can be a bit more involved, needing your personal ID number and proof of income. But if you go there with a company, then this should be able to be very doable. They should be able to help you. If you go the subletting route, make sure the contract is very detailed so expectations are understood between both parties.
Healthcare is top-notch in Stockholm as it's publicly funded. This is partly a reason why taxes are high there, but it's a great perk in Sweden. The quality is high, so you can feel comfortable getting a procedure done there if you need to.
Before we talk about working in Stockholm, we want to take a few minutes to give a few shout-outs to those of you who are commenting on our other review preview shows, just kind of what's going on. This type of comment is always going to get pulled out for special recognition. Sagar Zalabadia said, first viewer, thanks for being the first viewer and commenter on our Latvia video.
Another one from our last review preview video is this. I'm trying to understand, how can you be able to give advice when you're not living there? You were in Quebec, then you're moving to Portugal. You are confusing your viewers like me. Thanks for this comment so we can clarify things.
Yeah, these videos are a part of a year-long review preview series where we're going by the alphabet and we ask you, our audience, to vote on what city you would like us to break down and create a profile on. We use online resources and a large network of people that have lived in these places to help create these videos. We even try to source interviews for you all so you can hear from expats that have lived there after you've seen the city profile.
So hopefully that clears it up a little bit.
Yep.
Next, Christine Jones commented on a recent video about the top 5 reasons to be an expat in Singapore. Christine, thanks for the support. We're really appreciative of this kind of feedback. Sorry we didn't do this back in 2018 when you needed it, but we're glad you found us now.
All right, one more from the same video is from Ermdan. This is very beautiful. I enjoyed the delivery. I hope to relocate to Singapore, get married, and activate my traveling hobby. Really love you guys. Hey, we're really feeling the love. Thank you so much for the encouraging comment. We love you too.
And thank you to all of our subscribers as we've just passed 10,000 subscribers. And we are on this journey with you and we couldn't do it without you.
Yeah, we want to be creating these videos for you all full time. So each time that you hit the like button, share our content with someone that you know needs it, become a new subscriber, or even contribute positively in the comment section, that helps our growth. Thank you.
Let's talk about working in Stockholm. Like we've mentioned before, technology is a big industry in the city. Companies like IBM and Ericsson are there. You can also find Google, Spotify, H&M, and more. So lots of job opportunities for expats in the city.
Yep. lots of international businesses have a base in Stockholm. You also have those in green industry calling the city home. If you want to teach, check out international schools. The good thing is that you can find a job just knowing English because of the big international presence there.
There are, of course, jobs in the service industry, banking, finance, and more. Startups are big, like we said, in the city too. The good news is if you are an EU citizen, then you don't need to get a work permit. But if you're not from the EU, then you will need a work permit. Now, since Stockholm is in such high demand because of a great quality of life, finding a job can be a little difficult. But once you find a job, expect to have a good work-life balance.
If you haven't already, be sure to hit the subscribe button and notification bell to stay up to date on what's happening in the world of expats everywhere. On that note, let's quickly let you know what is happening in our world.
We continue to vlog about moving to Portugal as we are still waiting on those visas and the clock is ticking.
Yep.
We have our flights to Portugal for October 13th, so we have less than 3 weeks to get those visas. So fingers crossed that we get those, and be on the lookout because we will continue to vlog about that experience and when we get those.
We'll continue to interview expats from all over. We just interviewed Jake in South Korea, and coming up, we have an interview from Bali.
We're now moving on to the letter T. So if you are a subscriber, be sure to head over to the community tab page to vote for the next city. If you're not a subscriber, click the subscribe button to make your vote count.
Remember, we post these videos every other Thursday. That's all for this review preview show. We'll see you next time. Bye.
Bye.